Students,
in this class we are going to discuss about curve fitting and correlation for the given data points xi comma yi for the values I is equal to 1 to n. We have to construct a curve y is equal to f of x which satisfies most of the data points. It is similar to the interpolation. Interpolation means for the given set of data points, we have to consider an approximate polynomial. Curve fitting means what? Curve fitting means it satisfies most of the data points. This is the actual data points. This is the curve is required. Means what? There is a possibility of error is there. That error should be reduced with the help of the principle of least squares. And in the curve fitting, interpolation are closely associated methods. In interpolation, the fitted function should pass through all the given data points. Whereas, in the process of curve fitting, that curve satisfies most of the data points, which may or may not lie on the fitted curve. The difference between interpolation and curve fitting, while attempting to fit linear function, is illustrated in the adjoint figure. Now, how to fit the straight line for the given set of data points? Suppose the data points are p1 x1 y1 p2 x2 y2 like so on pn xn yn. N data points are given. Those data points are mentioned here p1 p2 p3 like so on pn. Some of the data points lies below the curve, the required curve. I am assuming this curve is y is equal to f of x. I don't know. This is the estimated curve or expected curve. These are the observed values x1 at x is equal to x1, y is equal to y1. I have taken all the positive quantities so that the data points lie in the first quadrant. It may lie in the second quadrant or third or fourth. For better understanding, I have taken set of positive paired values. And the errors will come into picture because the point far away from this point of contact with the distance L1, P1. L1, P1 I am calling it as E1. L2, P2 I am calling E2. Error. Is error? The expected value and observed. The difference between observed and expected is called error. Error may be positive or negative. Here error is positive and here error is negative. But the squares are never be negative. Their squares must be positive. So in the method of least squares, the author taken all the sum of the squares into consideration. E is equal to E1 square plus E2 square plus like so on plus EN square. That is sigma I is equal to 1 to N EI square must be minimized. What is EI? YI minus F of XI whole square. So according to maxima and minima principle, E should possess a minimum value when the partial derivatives with respect to the concerned parameters must be 0. The parameters depends upon the choice of the fitted curve. Suppose the fitted curve, it is a straight line. The straight line general equation is what? Any linear equation in x and y is called a straight line. Y is equal to ax plus b. Or one can take a plus bx also. A comma b are merely parameters. The parameter should be calculated with the help of the what? Least squares method. So here define e1 is equal to y1 minus f of x1 error observed minus expected. Expected means what? It should come after getting the curve. That I don't know. So yi minus axi plus b error ei general error I is equal to 1 2 3. E1 is equal to y1 minus f of x1. Take the squares of the sum of the errors. Then what are the parameters are here? A, b are the parameters, so that those values must be calculated with respect to the maxima and minima principle. Dou E by dou A is equal to 0 and dou E by dou B is equal to 0. With respect to A, if I am differentiating, this is capital X completely. Let us assume the function is capital X, X square. X square derivative is 2 into X. With respect to A, after 2 into A, the coefficient of A is how much? Xi. So Xi will come everywhere as a product. That after simplification, sigma I is equal to 1 to N xi into yi is equal to a xi into xi xi square plus b sigma xi. That will be the first normal equation. and dou E by dou B is equal to 0. When I differentiate with respect to B, what happens? Once again, it is of the type x square 2 into x. B coefficient is 1. So 1 will come everywhere. Sigma I is equal to 1 to n by I is equal to a sigma xi plus nb. Why n is coming? At I is equal to 1, the value is taking is b. At I is equal to 2, the value is b. And vice versa. At I is equal to n also b. So it will come nb. 1 and 2 are having a compulsorily a concurrent point, common concurrent point. That point of intersection is nothing but the median value of x and y. So solve those values 1 and 2 to get a comma b values. Both are linear in nature. We can solve those equations in scientific calculator also. Only thing is what? The statistical data is required. Xi, x into y, x square, summation of y, summation of xy, summation of x square, etc. Normal equations are not going to be changed. Only change is what? The sum value sigma y, sigma x square, sigma x, these values will come, will change. So once you are obtained a comma b value, substitute those values in the required curve. Required least possible fitted curve. That is y is equal to a plus bx. My choice is straight line a plus bx. So a comma b evaluation is nothing but fitting the curve of the straight line. Once again, I am repeating. A comma b values evaluation is nothing but fitting the most appropriate curve, that is the required straight line. The example you can see in example number 1, by the method of least squares, find a straight line that best fits the following data points. Now here, the student has to acquire the knowledge in the earlier discussion, how many data points are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Put n is equal to 5. And sum them, the first normal equation, sigma y, sigma xy is equal to a sigma x square plus b sigma x. How come this x is coming additionally? Because if I differentiate with respect to a, x will come as a product of y, x sigma xy is equal to ax is already there, one more x will come, ax square plus b sigma x. That is the first normal equation. What is the second normal equation? Dou e by dou b is equal to 0, according to the method. Yi minus f of xi. What is f of xi here? Axi plus b. F of x, axi plus b. So with respect to b, the coefficient is 1. So sigma yi is equal to a sigma xi plus nb. Why n is coming? B is a constant at I is equal to 1, at I is equal to 2 also b. Like so, I is equal to 5 also it is b, so 5b will come. So these are normal equations are not going to be changed for any straight line. These values are changed. The sum values, statistical values we have to calculate. Sigma y, sigma xy, sigma x square, sigma x. Those values are available here. Calculate those values. Get the values. Two equations, 4 and 5, they are concurrent. They must be consistent. Consistent means what? They possess a unique solution. That is, rank of A is equal to rank of B in your rank language. So they are concurrent. The concurrent point is what? A is equal to 1.9, B is equal to 1. In the scientific calculator, it will show x and y. But here, our requirement is what? AB. Substitute AB values in the assumed solution, y is equal to A plus BX. A is equal to 1.9, B is equal to 1. And you have a doubt. At X is equal to 0, what is the Y value here? 1. Put X is equal to 0 here, Y is equal to 1. Not 1, close to 1 will come. At X is equal to 1, Y is equal to 2. At X is equal to 1, 1.9 plus 1, 2.9. And here also it is satisfied. At X is equal to 3, 5.7 plus 1, 5.7. Plus 3.7 plus 1, 4.7. Here it is 4.8. There is a possibility of error. Anyhow, in the fitted curve, there is a possibility of error. The least squares method, our aim is what? To fit the most possible curve which satisfies most of the data points with possibility of error. Because with that error concept only, this method is developed. There is a possibility of error. There also illustration 2. Here, instead of x comma y, wf is given. W is the independent variable, f being the dependent variable. F is a function of w. Like x, y, the normal equation, the notation, the nomenclature will come. Instead of x, w will come. Instead of y, f will come. Only thing is what? The notational change. Sum them, get the value. fitting of a parabola, any second degree polynomial is called a parabola. Any second degree polynomial is called a parabola. In the parabola, the basic equation of the parabola, the structure of the parabola is ax square plus bx plus c. Depends upon abc values. It may be right open, left open, top open, bottom open, we can say. Our interest is what? To calculate abc values with the help of the least squares method. What are the tools are required? First of all, write the data points x1, y1 up to xn, yn, and error y1 minus f of x1, yi minus axi square plus bxi plus c, I is equal to 1 to n. Error is equal to what? Sum of the squares. That should be equated to 0 by differentiating partially with respect to the parameters a, b, c. Dou u by dou a is equal to 0, dou u by dou b is equal to 0, dou u by dou c is equal to 0. I will show dou u by dou a process. Dou u by dou a is concerned with respect to a, it is completely x square. X square derivative is not 2 into this internal function, yi minus axi square plus bxi plus c, like closed. Into with respect to a, the coefficient is what? Xi square. Into xi square will come. So what is happening logically? Xi square yi, this is the xi square yi is equal to axi power 4. How come? X square into x square, xi power 4. Plus b xi into xi square x cube plus c, 1 is there, 1 into x square xi square. You can write in terms of I or x also, because sigma means what? I is varying from 1 to n everywhere. Whenever you are writing normal equation, you write xi yi. Here xy notation is given, no problem, but you can understand. Sigma x means what? The sum of the x values. Sigma x square means the sum of the squares of the x values. Sigma x square means what? The product of sum of the x square y values, x square y sum values. Sigma x power 4 means what? The x power 4 sum values, like that. Similarly, we can calculate dou e by dou b, the coefficient is b, is xi. Xi will come everywhere, the second equation, xy, x square becomes x cube, x becomes x square, cx. And with respect to c, c coefficient is 1, sigma y is equal to a sigma x square plus b sigma x plus nc. Why nc once again? Sigma c. Sigma c means that how many times c is coming? N times nc. So only thing is what? Statistical data after writing the normal equations. What is the property of normal equations 2, 3, 4? Are always concurrent. They must pass through the unique point. That unique point is nothing but the solution. They are always concurrent. They are consistent. So sum them, get the values. The help of scientific calculator is allowed in the examination. This calculation you should must do with the help of the scientific calculator, the sum values, right? So we carefully have to do it, because curve fitting completely depends upon statistical data. If some value is changed, automatically it affects on the equations, automatically ABC values will be changed. So 5, 6, 7 solution in the scientific calculus, 3 unknowns, 3 variables. Give the values a coefficient, b coefficient, c coefficient, constant, a coefficient, b coefficient, c coefficient, constant. Similarly, the last equation a coefficient, b coefficient, in any order you can take, but in the calci it will show x, y, z. So wherever x is there, take a, wherever y is there, take b, the value c, a, b, c values you will get. Substitute these values in the required curve, y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. What is a value? Minus 0.07. B value 3.01, C is equal to minus 8.73. Like this, the 10 marks problem. Whenever parabola is asked, it is 6 to 10 marks will give, because lot of calculations you have to do, statistical calculations like this. Normal equations are not going to be changed. Only thing is what? The statistical data, the sum values are going to be changed. The change of scale is a different method. Leave it. Right, one method is enough for you. In the next class, how to calculate the remaining curves like power curve, exponential curve, geometric curve, we will discuss. Thank you, students. Thank you.